JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 24th. I am Charalambos, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded lower against most of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It underperformed the most against NOK, Kiwi, Aussie and the Canadian dollar in that order, while it lost the least ground against the Japanese yen. The greenback eked out gains only versus the Swiss franc and the euro. Now, the strengthening of the commodity-linked and oil-related currencies, combined with the relative weakness of the safe havens, suggests that market sentiment remains supported for another session. That said, although EU indices closed in positive waters, perhaps due to further recovery in oil prices, Wall Street gave back early gains, with S&P 500 and Nasdaq closing virtually unchanged. Dow Jones closed only 0.17% up. As for today, during the Asian session, risk appetite deteriorated further, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite sliding 0.83% and 1.11% respectively. Now, the change in investors' appetite may have been the result of a report that Gilead's potential medicine for the coronavirus failed its first randomized clinical test. The company said that the findings were inconclusive because the study conducted in China was ended early. This raised hopes that a vaccine is on the cards and may have revived fears that the virus could start spreading fast again if the stay-at-home measures are lifted too soon. Yesterday, although global deaths slowed somewhat, as you can see on the chart here, infected cases accelerated for the third consecutive day, raising concerns over whether the coronavirus has started leveling off. A new daily record may be enough to add to fears and result in another notable round of risk aversion. Now back to the currencies. The euro, although EU indices ended their session in the green, the euro was the second loser in line, perhaps due to the disappointing PMIs from the euro area, as well as the lack of progress in a virtual meeting between EU leaders, which was aimed at agreeing on a joint financial fund to help the union recover from the pandemic. Preliminary data revealed that the euro area manufacturing PMI fell to 33.6 from 44.5, hitting its lowest since February 2009 and missing estimates of 39.2. The services index fell to 11.7, its lowest ever, dragging the composite PMI down to 13.5 from 36. The UK and US preliminary PMIs also missed their estimates, suggesting that that despite the recent signs that the pandemic may be leveling off, the global economic outlook continued to deteriorate at the beginning of the second quarter of the year. All this adds more credence to our view that the economic wounds could well drag into the second quarter, and that even if governments start lifting slowly their restrictive measures, economies around the world may continue to suffer for a while longer before they start showing recovery signs. Now it remains to be seen whether the slump in the PMIs will prompt central banks to expand even further their stimulus efforts. Last week, ECB President Christine Lagarde said that she and her colleagues are committed to doing everything necessary within their mandate to fight the crisis, while on March 26th, Fed Chair Powell highlighted that the Fed is not going to run out of ammunition in its attempt to stimulate the economy. Thus, having all this in mind, we cannot rule out another round of easing measures to be delivered soon. Now, as for today's events, during the European Day, the German IFO survey for April is coming out. Both the current assessment and business expectations indices are expected to have declined to 81 and 75 from 93 and 79.7 respectively. This would drive the business climate index down to 80 from 86.1. From the US, we get durable goods orders for March and the final University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for April. Headline orders are expected to have tumbled 11.4% month over month after rising 1.2% in February, while the core rate is anticipated to have risen to minus 0.4% from minus 0.6%. This suggests that the tumble in the headline print may be due to the fall in aircraft orders, which appears to be a normal phenomenon, at least to us, if we take into account the travel bans and the hits the industry has taken due to the pandemic outbreak. Now, as for the University of Michigan index, it is expected to be revised down to 67.2 from 71. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. So goodbye. Have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.